second to you, you should, as we continue to use the wish upon you as we make a question for your business today.
Is it
But there's an example. Your desk. Close. Take your music and sing. So we sing.
Lord, my Thank you. the 5:30 and 9 o'clock. Walking down Mount Rock to the lake, like 600-700 people will see by the lake. It mixed with the cool air and storms with perfect out of nowhere. Remember, four of these disciples on this boat have been calling the ministry off of this very lake. Four of them, Matthew, James, and John, have spent more nights fishing with God the water than they seem to remember. And they were well acquainted with stories such as this from the this one was a real wow. And where Jesus sits on the hillside, you can see the waves rocking the boat, the wind beating the boat, and you can see how the water is completely chaos. The disciples have been at it for hours with buckets and pans trying to scoop the water out of the boat and trying to sink them. And when soaking wet, they're able to feel one another over the clouds of feathers, seeing only what is that breeze around them. And they see no problem in moving forward through the storm or backwards around it. Now, I hope that how many of us have experienced the news of the storms in our lives, where we all are standing in awe and amazement on the hillside of the Sea of Galilee, overflowing baskets and smiles on our faces, going from that to gale force winds and monsoons of rain. How long have we gone from saying, God, this is life, this is what we're all going through, to standing here? What's happened to my life? Everything is a mess. And usually this transition from joy to sorrow, from health to sickness, from elation to despondency comes in the biggest, big snap in the finger, with one phone call, with one test result at the high school, with one letter from the bishop, with one word, divorce. But here's the thing about storms and chaos. Here's the thing about water. God is well acquainted with all of it. In the beginning, the earth was chaotic, without form and void, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the water. For 4 days and 4 nights, the rain fell, and the goddesses of the earth gulped forth, and the ark was tossed to and fro in a turbulent sea. The people of Israel came to the Red Sea, knowing that Pharaoh and his army were not far from parting the sea, but frenzied. What's the scripture, friends, that you will often find in a lot of uncertainty go hand in hand? Water and fear, water and apprehension, water and chaos are mirrored in the pages of Holy Scripture. In the chaos of creation, what happened? God spoke. In the lawlessness of the flood, God preserved Noah and his family. The pandemonium at the Red Sea, God made a safe passage for his people. It's never an instance where the water is not cleaned by the speaking of God's God. So the love for his disciples, because Jesus Christ is the very architect of creation who was there in the beginning when the water was put into place. He walks on top of the waves, unabated by the wind, unconcerned with the current of battle or the wind to reach the boat and deal with this problem. Now, this is the point I'm certain we have to take our introspective into Peter, right? Let's dissect his actions and ponder why it is he doubted it was Jesus and asked to come along to the water in the room of the wind and water. Let's wrestle our fingers out here, shall we? And shame him for having such little faith. While insisting that we would never let ourselves be distracted God will take care of you.
Thank you. things in the faith, those we remember before you and rest the works of our hearts before you. Lord, in your mercy, you hear the end of our soul, Savior, we can tell us when we pray, trusting in your mercy, with your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Because Christ says the storms rage around us, like Noah and his family, we are found safely in the hope, in the ark, in the goodness of God's love and mercy. Go forth into the waves, and into the waves, and into the rain, knowing that your benediction is free. And go with this benediction and blessing, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you in favor and give you his peace. And from the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Pretending ever, O God, our help in ages past, is number 225 of the replay hymnal. Would you rise as we sit, please? Thank you.